there, Christy from Questacon. I'm just loving the energy in this room. I've got music, I've got lights, the Wi-Fi, the aircon, I've got a pizza on the way, and I'm gonna stream Star Wars episode 23 later on the hot tub. It's just energy, energy, energy. Woo! I love energy. What? Oh no, it's a blackout. It seems like we've run out of energy. Hi there, can you see me? This is what we do in an energy blackout. We go back several hundred years in technology. But I might need a light soon because this match is going to burn my fingers. This match was burning wood. This candle is burning wax. And they both produce heat and light energy from chemical energy. And you can see me just a bit. But this is a little awkward. Let's cheat in some lights. Hey, so what's some other ways that I could produce light myself though? I could blow air through this windmill. It causes the blades to turn, powering a tiny generator, and that transforms kinetic wind energy into electrical energy. I could wind up this torch, which also turns a wheel. And again, that transforms kinetic energy into electrical energy. But what happens when I run out of energy? I need a special sort of chemical energy that we call food. I eat it, and the energy allows my systems to function. My heart, my brain, my muscles, kidneys, my lungs, and more. A spoonful of sugar makes the medicine go down, but it also gives me enough energy to sit for a few hours or run 100 meters. But would you like to see me burn that energy really fast? I've got a small amount of sugar here, and if I blow it through a flame, whoa, check out that fireball! That release of energy. Now I should point out that when we eat food, we don't burn it like that. We digest it over many hours. Although sometimes a hot curry feels like that, am I right? But where does sugar get its energy from? Well, it's the same place we get most of our energy from. The one constant source of energy that our planet has. Right at the center of our solar system, it's the sun. The sun is 99.8% of the mass in our solar system. It's over 100 Earths wide. At its core, it's a million times the temperature of the Earth's surface, with a pressure 250 billion times our own. The sun is a nuclear fusion reaction where hydrogen atoms are squeezed together to make helium, heat, and light. It takes that light almost a million years to get from the center to the outside of the sun, but then only 8 minutes to get to us. Over 600 million tons of hydrogen are used up every second. However, the sun will burn for another 5 billion years. This means that in the context of human civilization, the sun's energy is renewable. Almost all the energy available to us comes from the sun. Gotta love that sun.